review. This has been one of the most requested song by you all the fans of Engaged Studios, Engaged Podcast. And this is U2's Drowning Man. This comes off of an album called War, one of my favorite albums from U2. And I think this is just something we should dive right into, because the hardcore fans are going to know this. There's a lot of biblical imagery in here, and we'll give the... I don't want to share what I think I know the song is about, because Seth here has never heard it. So this is his first time hearing this, so I'm excited for his reaction. So without further ado, this is Drowning Man. I think this came out like in 1983 or 4. You can... if it's not right, drop it in the comments. I know you're going to correct me. But anyway, this is Drowning Man.
It has like the Smiths sound to them. The second thing is I really like how the music, it doesn't sound like instruments. It sounds like industrial sounds. Like it has kind of like a raw industrial sound to it. I like it so far.
Mm. Thank you. thoughts, comments, insights, hit us with it.
It's a very unique song. It's like one of the most uniquer songs we've listened to. Uniquer, is that a word? If it's not, it is now. It's a good song. I liked it a lot. I'm not sure exactly what the meaning behind the song is. Mm-hmm. I was trying to follow it through the lyrics, and it wasn't. There wasn't anything sticking out to me that was like, oh, it's about this.
Mm-hmm. But generally, the vibe is what?
Reaching out to someone who needs help.
Exactly.
Okay.
So, and that's exactly what it is. So the word on the street is that Adam Clayton at the time was not a believer. I don't know where his heart is. Maybe you guys know where he's at in his faith. But more than that, apparently, and I've read this, and I hope it's true because I don't want to go out and say something like this about someone that's not true, but I've heard enough stories that he was an alcoholic at the time. Mm. And so they wrote this song for him, which makes sense. And it's, you picked up on that. You know, it's someone extending their hand of love to someone that's struggling. So this fits a lot of themes. I guess it could even be considered a love song in a sense, too. You know, what did you think about the music? Well, not the words, but the music.
I was going to say, I liked how the music, without the singing, the music part of it. Like I said in the beginning, it was kind of industrial, but it almost had like a chaotic feel to it, but that contrasted nicely with Bono's melodic, almost operatic, operatic singing. I thought, to have those two things play off of each other, two polar opposites, is a very hard thing to do. I thought it was done extremely well. I thought the guitar work was amazing, and I also was able to pick out the Edge singing based off of, but the other thing that's actually really interesting is that going from last week when we listened to 13 to going this week watching this video, seeing them at the beginning of their career, or, you know, watching them from the end of the career, most recent to an earlier song, it doesn't even sound like the same band.
Yeah. Well, there's that growth in maturity, you know?
Yeah.
I have just a few thoughts. One, just piggybacking off of the music, I loved how it built. Mm-hmm. It got more urgent. The music really painted the picture of a desperate person. Mm-hmm. You know, even if you didn't listen to this without words, you would go, oh my goodness, like, is this a soundtrack for Braveheart? You know, during a war scene or something. It had that feeling that there's something urgent to it.
Right. I would agree with that.
I also heard, and please confirm this, and this actually made me sad, that this song has never been played live in its entirety.
Really?
And I mean, if there's one song where you think where the band can get behind, especially in the younger days when Bono can belt this, man, I would have loved to have heard this or find something on YouTube. Now, we did look for little snippets, but we wanted to play the whole thing. So, if you're out there and you know more on that, leave us a comment. I guess the last thing I'm going to say is the Bible component. You know, he picks up on Isaiah 40. It's a super, super verse, and it's one that a lot of people know. And it goes, it's Isaiah 40, 31. Yet those who wait for the Lord, they will gain new strength. They will mount up with wings like eagles. They will run and not get tired. They will walk and not become weary. And Bono, I mean, he quotes it basically verbatim in the song. So that's Isaiah 40, 31. Overall, I got to tell you, I like the album more. This is where we get Sunday Bloody Sunday in October. A lot of the really, really good songs come from this album. I like the whole feel of it. Of the album. It has that urgent feel to it. So that's it. If you have any stories about this song or about the album War, leave us a comment. If we're missing something, drop it in the comments. If you have any personal stories with this song, I know a lot of people that do, that this song is very personal for them, for whatever struggles that they went through. Don't be afraid to drop that in the comments. We always interact with you all. And so we're going to sign off, but do us a favor. If you have not subscribed to the channel, Just hit the button, click it. You won't regret it. When you are laying down tonight, you're going to say to yourself right before you fall asleep, oh man, when I'm reviewing my day, am I glad that I hit that subscribe button? Because look how happy Pastor Anthony and Seth are now. All right, anyway, we'll connect with you next time. Stay blessed, and this is us signing off.